Last week, we focused a lot on how when you have a hot body, looks like an octopus, but it's a body, let's say. If it's hot on the inside and it's cold on the outside, then you will have some amount of heat transfer from the hot body to the cold body. It's simply a statement that, yes, energy flows. More than that, we're also interested in how fast it flows. It makes a difference whether you're losing 1,000 joules a second or 10,000 joules a second or even 100,000 joules a second. And so we're going to look at the rate of heat transfer. Now, heat transfer happens with three primary mechanisms, and we'll look at these one by one. In this question, we look at conduction, as you see here. There's also convection, which we're not going to go in too much depth about. And then finally, there's radiation, which we'll look at in the next example. Conduction is simply when you have two objects touching each other, connected by a certain amount of interface, how much heat transfers through the interface over a certain amount of time. Now, this interface will, of course, have a certain amount of thickness to it, and also a certain amount of area, supposed to be somewhat 3D. And similar to, say, electrical resistance, or just intuitively, you would think this power that we're transferring, we're going to get more heat across if we have a thin layer and also a large area. And also we'll get more heat across if there's a bigger difference in temperature between my two objects. If they're roughly the same temperature, you don't expect them to have a lot of heat moving through. And then to relate the two sides and also to reflect the different materials that the interface could be made out of, you have this coefficient K, which is your thermal conductivity. And this is again another thing we would look up in the table because of all the complexity. And for fatty tissue, we can look up this number to be 0.2. And we use this model to relate how your inside temperature is 37 degrees and the outside of your skin is 34 degrees. And through this whole solid mass, we have conduction. And we can work this out by plugging in the numbers that are given to us. And because the fatty tissue is quite thin, about 1 cm around your body, even though there's all kinds of curves on a human body, we can kind of smooth that out because the thickness is so thin here, and treat as one big slab, and it will still give us fairly good numbers. As you can see, the unit works out exactly to give you watts. And you get 84 watts, which should be easy enough to maintain. But you can also see from this equation here, the rate of heat transfer would increase if you're exposed or you're wet and then your skin temperature starts dropping and then you start to lose more and more heat. But in any case, you have conduction, you can count on this formula based on the temperature difference as well as the dimension and the material itself.